So hello guys, good day. So welcome to module one. So this is going to be a long one. So grab your coffee, your popcorn, simulan natin, okay? So microbiology is an exciting subject, guys. So I'll just give an overview on what you're going to expect. So the definitions, the different classification, different types of microorganisms, the history, taxonomy, and binomial nomenclature. So guys, microbiology is exciting, okay? Because we will going to introduce you of these organisms, yan, living organisms, actually, pati non-living organism. Because actually, technically, virus is a non-living organism, okay? Which includes bacteria, fungi, virus, parasites, specifically a protozoa. So a protozoa is a single-celled or unicellular parasite. And prions, yan. So prions are actually proteins that could cause disease. So here, sa mga GIF natin, so this is a cocobacilli. So bacteria yan. Ito, this is a budding yeast. Yan, kaya ngayong mga narinig nyo, yeast infection, ganyan. Candidiasis, ito, this is a corona virus under electron microscope. So guys, masaya ang microbiology. So we will discuss different significant microbes or microorganisms. So I'll just give you an overview, okay, kung gaano kaliit ang mga microorganisms. So what can we see in the naked eye is up to 1 millimeter only, guys. So your hair is only 1 millimeter, is 1 millimeter in width, okay? Anything that is thinner or smaller than that, hindi na makikita ng naked eye natin, okay? So your cells, yan, so they are 100 micrometers in size. So kailangan mo na ng light microscope. Yung mga parts ng cells, like your nucleus, makita pa rin sa light microscope hanggang mga bacteria. So light microscope yan. So the microscope that is available in school, in the laboratory, usually yun ang ginagamit para makita ang bacteria. So your bacteria is about 1 micrometer small. So 0.001 yan millimeter ang isang bacteria yan, 1 micrometer. So tama ba ako? 0.0001 yan ang micrometer. So anything smaller than a bacteria, guys, ito virus, like prions or then proteins, guys, kailangan na ng electron microscope, okay? So electron microscope in University of the Philippines Baguio, doon may electron microscope. Other than that, hindi ko na alam kung sino may electron microscope dito sa Baguio. So, hindi common ang electron microscope pa. So, hindi madalas nakakita ng virus unless you have an electron microscope. Okay? So, yung hanggang kaya ng light microscope natin, hanggang bacteria and fungi. Yan, kaya. So, this is an example of a light microscope. So, since we are looking at things in the micrometer range, so napakaliit, times 10 raised to negative 6. So kailangan ng microscope. And class, the principle of the microscope, that's why it can magnify images because it has two lenses. So basically, example, parang magnifying glass, it could magnify things just like a camera because there are two lenses involved, a series of lenses. So, dalawang lens involved. So, namamagnify niya ang isang bagay kung dalawa ang lens. So, saan yung mga lens dito? One lens is found in the eyepiece or ocular lens. And the one lens is found in the objective lens. Okay? So, there are three objective lenses. So, guys, I want you to be familiar with the anatomy, the parts, and the functions of a microscope. Okay? So this is a mechanical stage where we are going to place the slide, okay? So we're going to talk about your microscope further, pero hindi dito sa topic na yun. But I just want you to get to know your microscope, okay? So, simulan natin. So, what are the different types of microorganisms? So, first off, are your bacteria and your virus. Okay, so they are two different things, okay? So, to kill bacteria, you need an antibiotic. So, pag bacterial infection lang, okay? So, pag virus, kailangan muna ng antiviral, okay? But example, here, we have this coronavirus infection. And actually, yung mga may severe symptoms, sila lang yung nag-antiviral. Just like remdesivir. So, pag may, yung sa salita, meron ng word na vir, remdesivir, yun. So, it's an antiviral, okay? Pero, usually, hindi ba, pag viral, example, pag may trangkaso ka, ganyan, usually, it's self-limiting. Sandali lang. You could recover after a couple of days. Yan, it's self-limiting. No need for therapy. Ano lang, supportive. So, drinking a lot, lots of water, ganyan. So, ang antibiotic, guys, sa bacteria lang yan, okay? So, pag nagkatrangkaso kayo, huwag kayo inom ng antibiotic unless the doctor said so, okay? That's the only time that you will drink antibiotic, okay? At pang bacteria lang yon, okay? That's why we're learning here, okay? Huwag kayo inom ng antibiotic. So, bacteria are larger. Ibang unit na naman to, nanometer naman to. So, about kanina, 1 micrometer ang mga bacteria. So, its production is asexual production, which is binary fission. Pag-usapan natin to, pero yun, kunyari, isang bacteria to, binary fission, magiging dalawa. Yan. Tapos, yung daughter bacteria, magiging dalawalet. So, ganun ang binary fission. It's a sexual reproduction. Sabi ng teacher ko noon, boring daw maging bacteria. Kasi asexual reproduction. And treated with antibiotics, ayun. Unicellular. It's a living organism. Virus are not, okay? So, it's way smaller. You need an electron microscope. It's about 20 to 40 nanometers. It reproduces by invading a host cell, okay? So, viruses needs a host cell. So, also, like a pareho sila ng parasite, okay? However, parasites are living organism. It also needs a host cell so that it would get its nutrition. Yan. Kaya nga parasite yung pangalan niya. It needs a host cell. And basically, guys, virus is also a parasite. Kaya ka kayong lituhin. Pero ganun, kasi it requires a host cell. Eh. Kailangan niya ng victim. Kumbaga, kung saan siya doon magre-reproduce. It will take over the nucleus of a certain cell at doon siya magre-replicate. Okay. So, antibiotics will not impact virus. Okay. So, both can cause diseases. They do not have a nucleus. Yan. Yan. You could make vaccines out of bacteria. Example, tetanus. Yan, ganun. Kunyari, against tetanus, yan, may vaccine doon. Against TB, yan, may vaccine doon. So now, yung COVID natin, di ba? Yung Sinovac, Sputnik, Moderna, Pfizer, and so on. Capable of killing humans and raising human health. So, examples lang, class. I want you to be familiar, okay? Start familiarizing yourselves with different viruses and bacteria. So, notice how these are the scientific names, examples of significant, clinically significant bacteria. So, bacteria na mahalaga. Pag sinabing clinically significant, it's very important to be studied because many people are affected by the diseases that they cause. Okay, example, Helicobacter pylori. So, notice how we write the scientific name, guys. Ah. So, the genus, yung first name, kumbaga, has a capital letter on the first, at saka yung species, sabihin natin yung second name, small letter. So, ganyan magsulat ng scientific name. Okay? Example, sa marijuana, cannabis sativa. So, yung cannabis is the genus, capital letter yung C, tapos yung sativa, small letter. Okay? Example, sa dog, Canis familiaris. So, iba yung cannabis at saka canis. So, yung canis, letter C, malaki. Sa familiaris, small letter F. Ayan. So, notice here, streptococcus pneumoniae. Mahalaga to guys because it causes pneumonia. Ito, Clostridium tetani, para siyang lollipop. So, may spore siya. So, ito, Clostridium tetani, guys. It causes tetanus. So, pag nag-tetanus, example, is the constriction of muscles. So, yung example, lakjo. Yung, di niya magalaw. Di niya magalaw yung, ano niya, yung mandible ba to? Mandible niya, okay? Yung jawbone niya. Pag Clostridium botulinum naman, guys, so, instead na nagko-constrict yung muscle, sobrang soft naman yung muscle. Mamaya, I have photos. Itong treponema pallidum, it causes syphilis, which is a sexually transmitted disease, which is mahalaga. Very common sa Pilipinas. We have Vibrio cholerae, which causes the cholera pandemic. Hanggang ngayon, class, nagkakaroon ng cholera. Salmonella typhi, it causes typhoid fever. Naangkit ng mga itsura ng bacteria. Oh. So parang may mga hair-like structure yung Salmonella typhi. Itong Vibrio cholerae, yan, isa lang. Helicobacter pylori, it causes peptic ulcer. Diba? Plus, mahalaga. Staphylococcus aureus, in cases of acne, boils, kung may pigsa. Ito naman mga example of virus. Influenza virus causes your common flu. Coronavirus. May pitong coronavirus. Types of coronavirus. At isa na sa pinakasikat, ang SARS-CoV-2. Ebola virus. Noong 2015, nagkaroon ng outbreak lang. Epidemic of Ebola virus. Buti hindi naging pandemic. Adenovirus causes pagtatae, ganyan. Hepatitis B. Causes hepatitis, impacts the liver, inflammation of the liver. HIV, class. So, pag malala, nagiging AIDS, the fulminant form of HIV. Rotavirus, yan, it causes also pagtatae, gastroenteritis. Papillomavirus, HPV, matindi to class, causes cervical cancer among women and also in men. Herpes, depende. So it could also be a sexually transmitted disease. Ito class, oh, gusto ko lang, ang galing lang nitong pagkakaiba nitong bacteria nito. So Clostridium botulinum, it relaxes your muscle. It uncontrollably relaxes your muscles. It decreases your muscle tone. So parang ang tawag dito class, floppy baby syndrome. Tignan nyo, parang gulay yung baby. Sobrang hypotonic ng muscle. Parang gulay siya. Ito namang Clostridium tetani, it causes tetanus. Sobrang constricted naman yung muscle. Alam nyo ba, class, na itong Clostridium botulinum, kinukuhanan, ito yung toxin niya, guys, ginagamit sa bow, Tox, yan. So, di ba yung pag kunyari, may wrinkles ka. Yan, may wrinkles ka. So, tutusukan ng botulinum toxin or Botox para mag-relax. Yan. So, sa iba, pang pabanat ng mukha. So, pag may, ano, pag sa baby, yan, it could really weaken their muscles. Galing, no? So, I just want to give you an overview, guys. So, human coronavirus, actually pito, okay? So, itong mga types of coronavirus, COVID-OC43, yan. Ito, it causes common colds. Ito, sumikat to, MERS-CoV virus. Sa Middle East naman to. Ito, SARS-CoV, noong 2003 sa Hong Kong, nagkaroon ng outbreak. SARS. And ito na, SARS-CoV-2. Yan. So, yan, COVID-19 disease. Yan. So, dito naman, ang SARS naman, guys, it could easily die through sterilization. It's vulnerable to heat. Yan. because wala siyang envelope eh. However, it likes moist and cold surfaces. That's why it lives in the lungs. So, mycology, guys, is the study of fungi. So, hindi ba ang fungi is mushroom? But what those, pero yung mga fungi na pag-aaralan natin dito, guys, are microscopic, okay? Hindi yung mga mushroom na nakakain. The microscopic one and the one that causes diseases. So, bantay-bantayin nyo, guys, yung skin nyo. So, perhaps, hopefully, wala naman na ringworm. E kunyari, pag may pabilog sa skin, may time, sa mga estudyante ko, nakita akong estudyante ko, ang laki ng ringworm niya. Sabi ko, dear, pa-check up mo yan. Then, or bili ka ng cream, antifungal cream, kasi nakitaan ko siya ng ringworm. Yan. So, nakakahawa ang ringworm. Pag if you are borrowing towels or linens, may katabi ka, ganyan. So, regularly change. At hanapin niyo sa skin niyo. Athlete's foot, guys. The smelly feet, yan, check niyo. Because it could cause by a fungal infection, dandruff, guys, or itong mga tinyas. So these are caused by fungal infection. And ito, class oral thrush. So ito pag minsan, guys, madalas ang fungi, ang fungal diseases or mycosis. Mycology is the study of fungi. Okay. Bacteriology is the study of bacteria. Virology is the study of virus. Mycology is the study of fungi. So, itong mga fungi na to, class, madalas nagkakaroon lang ng tao if they are immunosuppressed, pag mahina ang resistensya. So, yun, madalas nangyayari ang fungal infections. So, palakasin lang ang resistensya. So, study of parasites or parasitology. Yeah. So, actually, ang rami-raming parasites. So, ito sa ngipin, it's Trichomonas tenax. And here, itong STD. So, ang mga parasites, so mga virus, pwedeng maging sexually transmitted disease. Ang parasite, pwede rin maging sexually transmitted disease. Example is Trichomonas vaginalis. There are parasites that are ectoparasites, which are parasites that are outside the host. So, example, ay yung mga kuto or hair lice, okay, hair louse. So, ectoparasites sila. Parasites which are on the external surface of the host. Yan. Hindi lumuloob ng katawan. So, endoparasite, yun yung lumuloob ng katawan, just like your trichomonases. We have obligatory parasite. Parasite that cannot survive outside the host. Kailangan nasa loob talaga sila ng katawan. Like your trichomonases. Your facultative parasite, they could live inside the host and outside of the host. Example is Tercoralis strongyloides. So, marami tayong pag-aaralan dito, guys. So, parasites, so that in order to live, they steal nutrients from a host. That's why they are called parasites. Yeah. So there are so many parasites, guys, especially here in the Philippines. Yeah. Since the Philippines is still an agricultural land. So class, ang madalas na parasites sa Pilipinas ay yung mga soil-transmitted helminthiasis. Soil-transmitted helminthiasis. So when people yan, tend to poop sa soil, guys. So, wala pa rin silang comfort room. Sa soil pa rin sila nagko-comfort room. Ayan. So, tapos may parasite doon. That's the perfect environment for a parasite. Tapos, kunyari, may mga bata. Naglaro sila ng soil. Ganyan. And they did not wash their hands before eating. Yan, kumain na sila. Yan, nalunok na nila yung, since they have soil in their fingers, may parasite doon, nalunok na nila. So that's the most common transmission of parasite here in the Philippines. At one common soil-transmitted helminthiasis is your ascaris or your roundworms. Hindi ba? May mga videos na kumakalat na ano, pag-ooperahan yung mga bata, ganyan. Yung ang raming parang pasta-looking worms. Yan. So, yan. Common yan sa Pilipinas. Yan. Itong mga hookworm. Mga parasite. So guys, this is a Strongyloides tercoralis, a facultative parasite. And ano, galing nitong GIF na to. So this parasite are, pag nasa loob siya ng katawan, your body fights it away naman. So these are your white blood cells trying to engulf, trying to kill the Stercoralis strongyloides. Strongyloides tercoralis parasite. You know, galing no? Galing ng katawan. So palakasin ang resistensya. So class, ma'am, why do we have to study this? Yan. So one common way of identifying bacteria in the hospital is culture and sensitivity. So we culture the bacteria, so we grow it, and after that we check for sensitivity. We will assess what antibiotic is suitable for that type of bacteria. So yung ito, yung antibiotic na may pinakamalaking zone of inhibition, area kung saan walang growth, ang tawag doon zone of inhibition, ibig sabihin yun yung pinaka-effective na antibiotic. Okay? So, kailangan nating i-identify ang bacteria para i-assess natin kung ano ang pinaka-effective na antibiotic na pwedeng gamitin. Okay? Kasi hindi lahat ng antibiotic gagana sa isang specific na bacteria, okay? There are specific antibiotics for each bacteria. So, we should be careful, okay? So, hindi dahil may antibiotic kayo sa bahay, iinumin nyo na yon, because not all antibiotic, okay, are the same, okay? Each antibiotic will target different types of bacteria, okay? So, iba-iba ang morphology ng bacteria, ng shape, ng structure ng bacteria. So, there are specific antibiotics for them. Okay? So, guys, wag inom ng antibiotic. Wag amoxicillin ng amoxicillin. Okay? So, there are specific antibiotic for each bacteria. Okay? So, at least, so, may kakilala kayo. Basta inom lang ng inom antibiotic, pigilan nyo. Okay? Hindi nakakabuti sa kanila yon. So, now we are in the history of disease causation. So, ayoko ilagay na history of microbiology because ang wide ng scope nitong topic na to eh. Anyway, just join me. So, let's go to history. So, now it's established, guys, that disease happens due to either environmental factors or inherent factors. So, nakakasakit, baka tumatanda, age, depends on the age, depends on whether you're a male or a female. Mga females, common sa atin ang mga cancer, at saka mga immuno, ang mga, tawag doon, yung mga immuno, mga systemic, parang, family of autoimmune diseases, yon, sorry. Mga autoimmune diseases like lupus. Sa ayaw natin at sa hindi, common sa mga babae yon. And males naman, guys, mas common sa kanila ang mga mental health problems. Maraming genetic problems na sa male lang. So, yon, inherent factors. And also environmental factors. At sa environmental factors, dito nalalabas ang mga bacteria. Example, if you are a farmer, hindi ka nagugas ng kamay, you are more prone to soil-transmitted helminthiasis. So, depending on your job, your class, your habits, so, mas magiging, it would cause disease. Yan. Example, kunyari, you are working in a industry wherein you are working with paint. So, pwedeng, you are exposed to lead, to harmful metals, and so on. So, these are the different factors that will result to disease. Established na yan, okay? But back then, ito kaya nga history of disease causation. So, wala pang discovery of bacteria, okay? Or microorganisms. Dati, ang causes ng disease is mga demons, ganyan. Divine wrath. Yan, because the god and goddesses became angry. Yan. Metaphysical, so depending on if the stars align, kung full moon ba, yung nagkakos ng sakit. High tide, low tide. Yan. So, they were believing different things back then about where diseases, why diseases happen. Yan. So, one way daw on removing the disease is transference. Example, scapegoat. So, kukuha sila ng goat. Yan. So, ewan ko, siguro dadasalan nila yung goat and they're hoping that the disease will be passed through that goat. Tapos, papatakbuhin na nila. That's why it's called the scapegoat. Yan. So, they do sacrifices or exorcism para matanggal yung sakit. So, that's what they knew back then. Okay? But here, Hippocrates, the father of medicine, said that it's not the supernatural which cause diseases, but natural causes. So, yun si Hippocrates na ang naging father of medicine. And he had the theory, which we call the theory of humors. Yan. Sabi niya, the imbalances of these humors, itong blood, phlegm, yellow bile, and black bile, ito daw ang nagkukos ng sakit. So, kunyari, pag mataas yung blood levels, mataas yung yellow bile, ganyan, it will result to disease. Imbalances of humors daw ang nagkukos ng disease. And, so, ito naman si Girolamo Fracastoro. He had, kung si humors theory or theory of humor si Hippocrates, ito naman si Girolamo, it's a contagion theory. Ayan. So at least nagkaka-concept na sila na nagkakaroon ng hawaan or transfer of diseases. And they thought that the transferring of diseases is due to seeds. Ayan. Hindi due to microorganisms. So hindi pa nila alam yun dati. So it's all about the passing of seeds daw. Ayan. So through direct and indirect contact. And he discovered syphilis. So, hindi ba binanggit ko kanina that the one that causes syphilis is Treponema pallidum. Yan. So, syphilis is a sexually transmitted disease. Yan. So, matagal na ng syphilis. So, nagkakaroon na sila ng concept na ang ibang sakit ay nakakahawa. Okay? And now, they have learned the practice of isolating. Diba? So, hindi ba ina-apply natin yan hanggang ngayon? So, kung nagkakatrangkaso ka na, you have to isolate yourself or quarantine yourself. Sabi nila sa 2021, the most used word in 2021 is the word quarantine. Yan. So, yung iba naman, kahit walang sakit, ang nakakalungkot guys, they isolated themselves. Okay? So, don't isolate yourselves kung wala kang sakit. So, they are having a concept that diseases could be contagious. Okay? But hindi lahat ng sakit nakakahawa guys. Ha? So, here, itong mga Chinese, they had practiced this concept of variolation. So, variolation, class matindi. Kasi yung smallpox ito, you have lesions or crust. So, kukuha sila ng lesions of the smallpox, didikdikin nila, class. Tapos, yung variolation, class, hihit-hitin yung smallpox. Addict ba sila kaya nila ginagawa yun? No. It's a way of them protecting themselves. Yan. Variolation. So, wala pang concept of vaccine nun, but variolation. So, yun yung crude way of vaccination, which is unsafe. Okay? Illegal na yan. According to WHO. So, you are infecting yourself with that disease. So, guys, smallpox has been eradicated. Okay? So, it's a good news. So, in October 26, 1979, class, smallpox was completely eradicated because of discovery of vaccine. So, guys, nung 1979, na-eradicate nila ang smallpox. Posible ba? Kaya na smallpox is a viral infection na ma-eradicate na rin natin ng COVID-19. Hopefully, di ba? Pero kasi right now, ang raming nasispread na misinformation, ang rami rin ayaw magpa-vaccine. Yeah. So, let's pray na ma-eradicate ang COVID-19 virus. Okay? So, next, ano na namang theory ang nag-arise noon? Itong si Aristotle. So, for 2,200 years, they believed that spontaneous generation theory or a biogenesis theory happened. So, they believed that living things comes from non-living things. So, kunyari, example, itong wheat. Sabi nila, pag iniwan mo yung wheat after a certain period of time, there will be rats. Hindi ba ang rats galing sa environment? Pero ang inakala nga nila, sabi nila, living things come from non-living things. So, yun yung pinanood na for 200 years, guys. And so, coming from that spontaneous generation theory, is, since, so, pinaliwalaan na nila that the pollution, bad smell causes disease. Bad air, nighttime air causes disease. The air, literally, causes disease. Okay? So, at least, nagkakaroon na sila ng concept that something that is dirty, yan, is causing disease. Okay? So, they are being conscious about sanitation and hygiene. So, dati, walang concept ng pagligo, ganyan, paglilinis ng kapaligiran. Now, they are doing it because they think that it could cause disease. Ang isang maduming kapaligiran. Okay? So, yun. We call it miasmatic theory of disease. Okay? So, wala pa silang concept of bacteria. Yung mga amoy-amoy pa lang. And now, here comes Francisco. Francesco naman to. Francisco Redi. Okay? Or Redi. Sabi niya, spontaneous generation, what a goofy idea. Let's test that belief. So, hindi siya naniwala sa spontaneous generation. So, ang ginawa niya, kasi back then, pinaniwalaan nila na pag nag-iwan ka ng karne, yan, manganganak ito ng maggots at saka flies. Okay? Pero nung tinest ni Francisco Redi, tinakpan niya yung isang lalagyan na wala namang wala namang tumubong fly, hindi ba, or maggots. Actually, doon lang nga sa lid sila pumunta. Okay, so it's not true. Yan, dinisprove niya ito. So, the flies and maggots were coming because it was not covered. Okay, hindi siya natakpan. Ito naman si John Needham. Sabi niya, hindi, totoo ang spontaneous generation. So what he did, he claimed that microorganisms could arise spontaneously from heated nutrient broth. So may gravy siya or isang nutrient broth. O, pinakuluan niya pa ha. This flask is open. And yun, nagkaroon ng microorganisms. Yan. Pero dinisprove siya ni Spallanzani. Yan. Sabi niya, nagkaroon ng microorganisms because you did not cover the flask. Okay? So the microorganisms were carried by the air. So, nung ito, pinakundo niya yung nutrient broth or yung gravy, tinakpan niya, yan, tinunaw niya yung cover, and it was free of microorganisms. Of course, it was not exposed to air because the air will carry the microorganisms, okay? So, the dust particles in air has microorganisms. Ayan. So, nagkakaroon na tayo. So, scratch, buti na lang, nawala yung abiogenesis. So, what is accepted now is biogenesis. So, we now believe that living cells arise from pre-existing cells. Okay, living cells are from living cells. Okay? So, magkaroon na tayo ng cell theory. So, tatlo yun. Si Matthias Sladen, sabi niya, all plants are made of cells. Sabi ni Theodore Swan, all animals are made of cells. Sabi ni Rudolf Virchow, all cells came from pre-existing cells. Ibig sabihin, a cell comes from an ancestor cell. May pinagmanahan, okay? So guys, do not be confused by the word theory, okay? So sa science, when we say theory, actually, it's already an accepted truth, okay? So, ayun. So tatlo yung statement ng cell theory. It was coined by Matthias Sladen, Schwann, and Virchow, okay? So living cells came from pre-existing cells. So ikaw, galing ka sa pre-existing cells ng parents mo. So here we have now Louis Pasteur, which is the father of modern bacteriology. And guys, I want you to appreciate, diba, what they are doing in the concept of microbiology, because up to now we are applying these concepts. So here for Pasteur's experiment, the same thing eh. So parang kay Spallanzani rin. So meron siyang nutrient broth. Yan. So nakatakip. So to now, naka-close yung Nutrient Broth. Even though 1 year na ang nakalipas, talagang walang tumutubong microorganism unless you will open or break the glass, okay? And I expose it to air, okay? So now, it will be filled with microorganisms, yeah. So, due to Louis Pasteur, the father of modern microbiology, nagkaroon ng term which is aseptic technique, okay? So, measures to prevent the contamination of living tissue. So, class, applying alcohol to the skin is a way of aseptic technique, yan. So, prevent contamination of living cells. Class, hand washing is a form of aseptic technique on living tissue. Pag nililinis mo ang living tissue, guys, it's called aseptic technique, okay? If you are cleaning a non-living area, non-living yung table mo, that's called disinfection, okay? So, aseptic technique is, if you have a skin, you're applying iodine on it, yan. So, aseptic technique yun. Pag disinfection, you're cleaning your cell phone, the keyboard. And we have this term, guys, pasteurization. Yan. So, dati, class, nung panahon ni Louis Pasteur, the wine industry, the brewing, the beer industry, class, has a problem because they have a microbial problem. Nasisira agad yung wine, nasisira agad yung beer. So what? Nasisira yung milk. So what Louis Pasteur suggested is pasteurization, wherein you should heat your wine, your milk, the beer, below boiling point to destroy the microorganism. Okay? So dahil kay Louis Pasteur, na-save ang wine industry, na-save ang brewing industry ng France, including the silkworm industry. Yan. He noticed that some of the silkworm are getting diseased. Namamatay yung mga silkworm. So what he did is, in-isolate niya yung may mga sakit na silkworm. Okay? Pinatay niya yung may mga sakit na silkworm para hindi mahawa yung mga healthy na silkworm. Okay? So because of Louis Pasteur, different industries were saved. Galing, no? In class, yan. Ano lang, isang butil ng knowledge. We have Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So this is the brewer's yeast. This is a fungi used in making beer. Okay. So, ito na. Nagkaroon, dahil kay Louis Pasteur, nagkaroon na ng germ theory of disease. So, scratch na yung mga miasmatic disease. Scratch the abiogenesis. Yan. So, nasa germ theory of disease na tayo. That some diseases, not all, are caused by germs or bacteria. Okay. So, itong germ theory disease, tama naman siya, but microbes as the sole cause of disease, hindi naman, okay? Pwedeng hereditary, lifestyle, genetics. Yan. So, this one, guys, this is Bacillus anthracis. Mamaya pag-usapan natin. So, guys, furthermore, yan, ang rami pang mga discoveries. Ito, favorite ko to. We have Ignaz Semmelweis, okay? So, Ignaz Semmelweis noticed na may dalawang lying-in clinic, okay? Kung saan nanganganak ang mga pregnant women where they have their labor. Okay? So, in lying-in clinic, class, may mga doctors. Yan. And they noticed that in lying-in clinic, there is increased death among women, yan. At namamatay sila sa childbed fever or puerperal fever. They had infection after childbirth, yan. So, yung may dalawang panganakan. And Ignaz Semmelweis noticed, ang taas dito sa lying in clinic letter A kumpara sa lying in clinic letter B. Yan. And he found out that the doctors who are in duty in lying in clinic A, guys, after or before dealing with the pregnant women, guys, they are handling dead bodies. Yan. They are doing autopsy on dead bodies, yung mga doctor dito sa lying in clinic. That's why, guys, Ignaz Semmelweis said that he insisted that physicians should wash their hands, okay, with chlorine solution in between patients, okay? So that was the solution. Why? In the first clinic, ayan, first lying in clinic, the nabawasan yung death ng mga mothers, okay? So napigilan ang childbed fever or puerperal fever or streptococcal group A infection after childbirth. Ayan. So, dahil sa paghugas ng kamay. So, noong 1846, doon pa lang na-implement ang paghugas ng kamay. Okay? So, galing no, guys? So, thank you, Ignaz Semmelweis. Ignaz Philip Semmelweis. Here, we also have Joseph Lister. So, dati, hindi uuso ang pag-disinfect ng surgical equipment. But dahil kay Joseph Lister, yan, he is the pioneer of antiseptic surgery. So, i-disinfect. So, pag-disinfect non-living things. So, using carbolic acid or phenol. Yan, galing, no? So, Ignaz Semmelweis, hand washing. Joseph Lister is the disinfection of surgical equipment. So here, guys, also, we have, finally na, siguro, ay, hindi, meron pa. This is Robert Koch. So, Robert Koch has a postulate, sabi niya. So, example, itong lamb na matay. So, the same microorganisms are present in every cause of this, in every case of disease. So, meron siyang four postulate. So, namatay itong lamb. So, kung may bacteria sa lamb na to, igogrow mo sa isang culture, tapos, i-inject mo sa isang rat. So, that rat will be infected with the same disease. Okay? Tapos, namatay rin yung rat. Nung kinulture mo yung bacteria sa rat, dapat magkapareho. Okay? So, yun yung postulate ni Robert Koch. Pasahin ko na. Postulate 2, microorganisms are isolated from the lamb in a pure culture. So, pag dapat pareho yung... So, kung since the same naman yung in-inject mo sa rat, dapat yun rin, pag kinulture mo na yung dugo ng rat, dapat yun rin yung lalabas na bacteria, okay? So ang ginamit niya is anthrax bacilli. So it causes anthrax, or this is Bacillus anthracis, causes anthrax. So dati, guys, yung anthrax ginamit for bioterrorism. So what they did is they got an envelope, tapos nilagyan nila ng anthrax spores. So pag binuksan mo yung envelope, kala mo may love letter ka, nalanghap mo yung spores, yan, it will cause a deadly lung disease. Yan, so yun. Ginamit ng mga terorista. So class, here we have Edward Jenner. So Edward Jenner is the pioneer of vaccines. Di ba ngayon, parang marami rin namang talagang anti-vaxxers. Yan. Paano pa sa time ni Edward Jenner, he pioneered vaccine. Okay? And because of him, the first vaccine was created, which is smallpox vaccine. And they eradicated smallpox. So, paano niya ginawa yung smallpox vaccine? By getting a cowpox. Okay? So, nakuha niya yung theory kasi milkmaids, yung mga milkmaids, yung mga kumukuha ng milk, guys, milkmaids, is pag nagkaroon daw sila ng cow, nai-infectionan sila ng cowpox because of their exposure from cows, okay? So they have, yung cowpox class, it's like a mild form of smallpox. So those who had cowpox, hindi na sila nahahawaan ng smallpox. So what he did, guys, for the first vaccine is he was infecting people with cowpox. Yan. So very ano siya, very scandalous. Sabi niya, ha? Hahawaan mo kami ng sakit para hindi kami mahawaan ng mas malalang sakit. Yes, exactly. So ganun ang ginawa. So ang una niyang tinurukan, yan, is a minor. Yan, ininfekta niya ng cowpox itong bata. And this, itong batang to, hindi nagkaroon ng smallpox, which is a deadlier disease. Galing, no? And here, meron naman tayo, ito, napaka-revolutionary ng discovery ni Alexander Fleming. He discovered the first antibiotic. Yan. So, he had a culture of Staphylococcus aureus and he left it in his laboratory. Yan, naiwan niya. And after a couple of days, tumubo ang mga fungi, which is Penicillium notatum. And he noticed that the Penicillium notatum has killed the Staphylococcus aureus. So yung fungi na to, pinatay niya yung bacteria. So now, he converted this Penicillium notatum into a pill, which is penicillin. Now, dahil dito, diba, we could perform yung mga surgery, like hindi ka pwedeng magpabunot. Tapos after nun, di ba, inom ka ng antibiotic. So dati, maraming namamatay sa bunot because walang antibiotic. Yan. Maraming pwedeng mamatay sa heart surgery kasi wala silang antibiotic after. Yan. So because of antibiotics, yan, the science of medicine has really expanded. And it saved a million of lives. Yan. In war, di ba? Yan. And we have Paul Ehrlich. So ito, this is a chunk canker caused by a bay syphilis, and syphilis single L. So he discovered magic bullet called Salvarsan. Yeah. So ito na. Napapatay na natin ang mga bacteria. Yeah. So yun na, that's the end of the history. And finally, patapos na tayo, guys. So we have taxonomy. So I want you to focus on the genus and the species. Yan, sa scientific name natin. So example, ang scientific name ng humans is Homo sapiens. So if we are going to do taxonomy, so it deals with the description, identification, nomenclature, and classification organisms. So domain, eukarya, kingdom, animalia. So kingdom, animalia tayo. So pag plant, kingdom, flora, or plantilla. So phylum, chordata. Class, mammalia, we are mammals. Order, primates, family, homo, hominidae, genus, homo, species, sapiens. So homo, sapiens. So example man is a bacteria. Example, Escherichia coli. So its domain, it's bacteria. Phylum, proteobacteria. Class, gamma, proteobacteria. Order, enterobacteriales. Family, Enterobacteriaceae, genus, Escherichia, species, colon. So, ang mahalaga lang dito guys, yung genus at yung species, okay? So, lahat na ng under bacteria, ang domain, syempre, bacteria, okay? Pag animals, plants, yan, eukarya tayo. Kasi we have eukaryotic cell. So, yun lang. So, class, so we have, finally, yun, I just want you to take note about the scientific name or binomial nomenclature, okay? The system of naming. So, si Carolus Linnaeus ang nag-introduce nito. So, please ha, so pag yung genus, capital letter yung first letter, and yung species, small letter. So, ganyan magsulat ng scientific name, okay? So, guys, that's the end of our module. Thank you for listening. Bye.